Hi, today I'll be showing you how to set up gears for threading on my Vivor lathe. First, I want to identify the pitch of the thread I want to make, so I'll be using this pitch gauge. After playing around and finally matching the correct size, I now need to find that on the threading chart. There are two charts on this lathe. Standard, for those who measure everything with the size of their feet, and metric, for those who realize feet come in many different sizes. The pitch I need calls for four gears, 60, 40, 80, and 50 teeth. The letter H, or X, or anything that's not a number, is basically a space that needs to be filled with something. The way threading works is spindle drives one gear, that gear drives another and another until it finally reaches the gear that drives the lead screw. So depending on the gear teeth count and where they are placed, lead screw turn ratio to the spindle turn ratio will change, but you already knew that. So let's remove all the gears, bolts and C washers, and be sure you're left with at least that many parts. Also, there's a little key from the gear that was driving the lead screw. Now let's get the gears the chart was telling us about. 40, 50, 60, and 80. Now let's look at the chart where it's supposed to help you identify which gear goes where. Specifically the area here where gears correspond to letters. And now forget about everything you just saw, because this image was made by idiots to confuse you. In fact, don't even bother with letters on the chart itself. Focus on numbers instead. If it says 60 on the left and 40 on the right, and it's on the top row, then you put 60 left, 40 right on the top of the gear rack. Then you have 80 on the right in the middle and 50 on the right at the bottom. Now here's why you may be having trouble. The spacer at the bottom gear is too long for this configuration. You're going to need to make shorter spacer. It has to be long enough to prevent the gear from rubbing the gear rack. So following the chart, I have 50 teeth gear on the right. And now you ask, what is the gear on the left? Well, I did it because the chart said I need a spacer there. So I simply used whatever gear I had laying around as a spacer. I picked the smallest gear available so it will not interfere with other gears that may go above it. Then I put 80 on the right, following another small gear on the left as a spacer. Then I put 40 on the right and 60 on the left. So what we end up having here is, spindle drives 60. 60 and 40 are on the same shaft. 40 drives 80. 80 drives 50. And 50 drives the lead screw. Next step is to decide which direction thread is going to be cut. In my case, it's forward or normal thread. And the speed shifter has to be set to medium speed. Otherwise, thread will not match. I don't know 100%, but I think medium, high, and low correspond to normal, coarse, and fine threading. Don't quote me on that. I'm still learning it myself. Then, what you typically do is a scratch pass, just to verify that the scratch you made matches the pitch gauge, and then start cutting your thread. In my case, thread is very short, so I turn the chuck by hand, back and forth slowly, increasing the depth of cut each pass, until I get to where I need. Then I'll do one more pass to remove all the burrs, and that's it. Not the most beautiful thread in the world, but you get the idea. If this video helped you, please don't hesitate to give it a like and subscribe for more. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you later. Bye bye.